Now, let us complete the FRA part and do the IRF part in the next stage. Please. Shh. Please, yeah. Now only switch down. Another, I'll complete this sum and change the AC status quo. Can I push it or not? 5 minutes. Shh. See. Stop talking. Now, I want to borrow. I want to what? Borrow. For my cash management purpose. Because next 6 months period is going to be cash crunch period, okay, where I require money to finance my expenses, working capital requirement. Everybody following or not? Now, I want to borrow how many million? 50 million. The crash crunch is going to happen today, after 3 months. Today, after 3 months, after 3 months. See, look at my position. I now forecast that after 3 months, I will require how much million? 50 million. Say, for how many months period? 6 months period. Enna paisa no? Correct? No. Normally, the crash crunch period is how many months here? 6 months. 6 months, I'll be having a headache regarding cash. Are you following that? No. The 6 months period is going to start from today. After 3 months. After 3 months. All this data are available from what? The question itself. Yes or no? The slack session is going to start about what? 3 months. After 3 months, the slack session starts. And there is no demand for my product. I don't have the revenue to what? Boost my expenses. In such a case, what happens is, I have to go for a finance. I want how much finance? 50 million as a finance. For how many months? Yeah, 6 months. Because the slack season is for 6 months. And peak is for what? 6 months. Everybody, are you following or not? To put it simply, I want to borrow for how many months? 6 months. After what? 3 months. I'm having a risk or not? Because today if I borrow, look at the workbook. Today if I borrow, how much percent? 5.75%. I'm borrowing today after 3 months. After 3 months. We're going to borrow after 3 months. Is the interest rate certain or uncertain? Uncertain. I'm worried about the interest rate. Yes or no? So what I do is, I go to the bank, enter into what? Forward rate agreement. Is the FRA anything to do with my loan transaction? No. It's a separate agreement. It's not known. But that agreement should hedge my loan. Are you fine what I'm saying? In that case, my loan is between 3rd month to 9th month. Yes, sir. The loan is between what? 3rd month to 9th month. That means I can select 3 into 6 FRA, 3 into 9, 3 into 9. The question, made you select FRA here properly? So no. FRA is what? 3 into 9, because I am going to borrow after 3 months. How many period? 6 month period. To match that borrowing, I select what? A proper FRA. Yes or no? Now that means I go for a 3 into 9 FRA. In the Papunjara? No. In this, next question is, 5.64 is that, 5.94 is that, yes or no? Isn't it correct? No. This 5.64%, 5.94% is that, what can say? The quotation is what? Quotation given for a reference rate. Given for what? Reference rate. Any reference rate name given? Okay. We can assume the name to be what? MIBOR. Assume the name to be what? MIBOR. So, 5.64 and what? 5.94. The reference rate for what? A MIBOR. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? Now the question is, are you going for a 5.64 or 5.94? 5.94, because I want a forward borrowing rate. I want a forward what? Borrowing rate. Everybody, yes or no? Can you put that? That means, very simple. I say that I will agree to, all of you tell me, I selected this 5.94, I'm going to what this 5.94. Tell me, I have agreed to what? Buy. I agreed to what? Buy MIBOR. I agreed to what? Buy MIBOR. At the banker's selling rate. Yes, sir. Same currency, man. I agreed to buy the dollar at what? The banker's offer rate. Yes or no? No. I agreed to buy MIBOR. This I will not call as MIBOR. I call as MIBID. I call as what? MIBID. That means what? Mumbai Interbank Bid Rate. Are you following what I'm saying? It call as what? MIBOR. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, I agreed to buy at bank's selling rate. What are they? Offer rate. I agreed to buy MIBOR by paying how much? 5.94. I agreed to buy MIBOR today. After 3 months. After 3 months. For how many months period? 6 months period. Is the meaning of this transaction? Yes or no? At the end of the 3rd month, the MIBOR may turn out to be what? 4.5%, or may turn out to be what? 6.5%. In both the cases, they are saying you, how it is hedging is a question. Everybody, are you following or not? Yes, sir. Now, you have to read so much to understand what question. Once clarity is there, 1 minute answer can be done. Everybody following or not? No. I am spending time again to make you comfortable about the wordings or terminologies or language. Okay. Now, all of you together tell me. Now, I have a crash crunch. I have what? A crash crunch. Now, after 3 months. For meeting the crash crunch, I want how much loan? 50 million loan. For how many months? 6 months. Is the loan to be made today or after 3 months? I am afraid about rising interest rate or falling interest rate. Rising interest rate. Yes or no? No. To protect myself, I go for what? FRA with the bank. Okay. FRA linked to loan, not linked. Not linked. With a separate transaction. I go for a 3x6 or 3x9 FRA. Because my loan is between 3rd month and 9 month. My forward also be between what? 3rd and 9 month. Yes or no? Now tell me, I am going to borrow tomorrow. I am going to deposit tomorrow. I'm going to borrow a deposit or borrow. Since I'm going to borrow tomorrow, I want a forward borrowing rate. I want a forward borrowing rate. That means I'm going to buy what? MIBOR. I want to buy MIBOR at the banker selling rate of 5.94%. 5.94%. Tell me what is the meaning of that? I have agreed to buy, agreed to what? Receive MIBOR and pay what? 5.94%. After what? 3 months. And the MIBOR becomes, for example, 4.5. I receive what? 4.5 and pay what? 5.94. I'll be having a profit or loss or loss. If the MIBOR becomes 6.5, I receive what? 6.5 and pay what? 5.94. Profit or loss or profit. Yes or no? Now, in this case, I have a loss or not? You know, when the MIBOR drops to 4.5, I am angry because I receive what? 4.5. I pay how much? 5.94. I will cry a laugher. I will cry, but laugh as a borrower because I had to borrow only 4.5%. Yes or no? When the MIBOR falls, I will laugh as well as what? Cry. I am a hedger. Yes or no? In that case, I laugh because my borrowing cost has reduced to what? 4.5. I will cry because I have to pay what? Compensation to the bank. Yes or no? Now, when the MIBOR increases to 6.5%, I cry as a borrower because I have to pay what? More interest rate at the time of borrowing. But I am happy because I have been receiving what? Compensation from the bank. It is going to lock me at what? A given 5.94% interest rate. In the parallel falling or not? That's all regarding the forwarded agreement problem. Can I proceed or not? No. Can we do it together? No. This sum is going to be very similar to question number 2 what we did. It could be sometimes very similar to question number 2 what we did. Can I start or not? No. Right on. Forward rate agreement. Electra Space needs to borrow. Electra Space needs to borrow for 6 months. Electra Space needs to borrow for 6 months. After 3 months, Electra Space needs to borrow for 6 months. After 3 months, hence, should use. Hence, should use, fill out the blank, should use what? 3x9 FRA borrowing rate. Hence, should use 3x9 FRA borrowing rate at 5.94%. Hence, should use 3x9 FRA borrowing rate at 5.94%. At 5.94%. Everybody, are you following or not? No. I did not use MIBOR and all, they have not given it. I just only explained you the reference rate. I think you're able to understand or not. Can I proceed? No. Next. Part A. Interest rate becomes 4.5%. Interest rate becomes 4.5%. Interest rate becomes 4.5%. Can we start or not? No. Locked in interest rate as per FRA. Locked in interest rate as per FRA. Tell me what is a locked in interest rate as per FRA? How much percent? 5.94%. 5.94%. Actual interest rate. Tell me on the fixing date, what the actual interest rate? You write actual interest rate on fixing date. Actual interest rate on fixing date. How much percent? 4.5%. Answer me. I have agreed to pay 5.94% in exchange for what? 4.5%. Client is above? Now, I have to receive compensation or pay compensation or pay common. Compensation paid to bank. Compensation paid to bank. How much percentage? 1.44%. Compensation paid to bank, 1.44%. Amount of compensation paid to bank. Amount of compensation paid to bank. Now, answer me. How much percentage? 1.44% on how much million? 15 million. To be calculated for how many months? How many months here? 6 months. 3rd to 9th month is what? 6 months. In my son, no, now write down. 50 million into 1.44% into 6/12. 50 million into 1.44%. Remember? 36,000. Euro, rupees, let's make a change, no problem here. Okay, question made as what? Rupees. Okay. 50 million into 1.44% into 6/12. Number correct? Huh? What number? 3 lakhs? 60,000. 50 million into 1.44% into 6/12. 3 lakh 60. Are you getting it or not?
Yes, sir.
What is the number? Now, next is interest on loan. Interest on loan. Tell me the loan I'll borrow the money at what percent? 4.5. On that day's interest rate prevailing. Yes or no? Now, it is 50 million into everybody. 50 million into what? 4.5% into 6/12. 50 million into 4.5% into 6/12. Is equal to how much? 11,25,000. Should I add or subtract? Add. Both are payment. Write down total outflow. Total outflow. 11,25,000 + 3,60,000. 11,25,000 + 3,60,000 is equal to 14,85,000. Total outflow is 14,85,000. 14,85,000. Everybody, are you falling or not? Now, next, part B. Can I proceed? My part B. Interest becomes 6.5%. Interest becomes 6.5%. Locked in interest rate as per FRA. Locked in interest rate as per FRA. 5.94%. Locked in interest rate as per FRA. 5.94%. 5.94%. Actual interest rate on fixing date. Actual interest rate on fixing date. What is the actual interest rate on fixing date? 6.5%. Actual interest rate on fixing date, 6.5%. Now, tell me I should pay compensation receiver. And I agree to receive MIBOR by paying what? 5.94. Since the MIBOR is 6.5, I am a net receiver, a net payer, a net receiver. Compensation received from the bank. Compensation received from the bank. How much percentage? 0.56%. 0.56%. Amount of compensation received from the bank. Amount of compensation received from the bank. Amount of compensation received from the bank. What into what? 50 million into 0.56%. 50 million into 0.56%. Into what by what? 6/12. 50 million into 0.56% into 6/12. Tell me the amount. 1,40,000. Can I write as euro? The question is given in euro. I just wrongly typed as rupees. Can I proceed or no? Next. Interest on loan. Interest on loan. What is a loan interest? Tell me. 50 million into how much percent? 6.5% into 6/12. 50 million into 6.5% into 6/12. Give so much, sir. 16,25,000. Is equal to 16,25,000. 16,25,000 total outflow 16,25,000 minus what? 1,40,000. 16,25,000 minus 1,00,000, because I am receiving compensation, it should be what? Reduced. What the number I am going to get? 14,85,000. Number is 14,85,000. Now, answer me, when the interest rate was 4.5, what I paid? 14,85,000. When the interest rate is 6.5, what I paid? 14,85,000. Suppose interest rate is 80%, what I paid? Same 40. Whatever may be the interest rate on future, I have hedged my what? Outcome. Everybody yes or no right now? Next. Conclusion. Whatever be the interest rate, whatever be the interest rate prevailing after how many months? 3 months. Whatever be the interest rate prevailing after 3 months, the company has locked itself for an interest payment of, the company has locked itself for an interest payment of, for interest payment of how much is 14,85,000. The company has locked itself for an interest payment of 14,85,000, or how much percent? 5.94%. Or 5.94%. Locked itself interest payment of 14,85,000 or 5.94%. This is what is the forward rate agreement. Everybody yes or no? No. When I study the next chapter, interest rate swap, we call swap as nothing but a series of forward rate agreement. That's all. If you understand this properly, we can move smoothly into the interest rate chapter later. Everybody, are you having the clarity or not? No. No. Next is interest rate futures. Little bit different than the others. You have to understand it much more carefully. Give the heading interest rate futures. Interest rate futures. Okay. See, a little bit of patience is required to understand the interest rate future. Seems to be a little bit complicated in the beginning. How we had for the futures, it's on over now, is the exchange traded instrument. Seems to be a little bit complicated in the beginning, but once we get set, it becomes very, very easy. Like that only we had FRAs also at the beginning to understand, and this is something different, the modus operandi is different. So now let us see how the interest rate futures works. Okay, now please stop talking. Forward rate agreement is done in a stock exchange, done between two parties. Done between what? Two parties. The rate MIBOR may be published by one stock exchange, you take that rate, that's a different issue. But it's the over-the-counter agreement where two parties, a bank and its customer, separately enter into an agreement called as what? Forward rate agreement, where we'll be exchanging the interest rates. Are you following what I'm saying? Now, see, same forward rate agreement, if you do through an exchange, you don't want an exchange, stock exchange, it is called as what? Futures. It is called as what? Futures. Okay. See, interest rate futures is a derivative. It is what? Derivative. Means trader in what? Stock exchange. NSE is having what? An interest rate future segment. Everybody following what I am saying? It is trader in what? The stock exchange. This interest rate futures works ditto in the same way how the futures market works. In the same way what? How the futures market works. Where there is standardized contract size, where the settlement is made otherwise through what? Delivery, by giving a counter buy and what? Counter sell. Where if you want, you can even exit before what? Maturity date, by giving a counter buy and counter sell to some other party. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? And there's a standardized contract size. One cannot go for any amount you like. You should be having what? A standardized contract size. Like open interest, it'll be there in what? Interest rate futures, bid, that is the bidding process will be what? The taking place. Daily the future price what? Moves up and down. Whatever happened in futures market, ditto happens in what? Interest rate futures. There we are trading what? Share, buying and selling share. You want to want a buy or sell interest, that's all. Yeah. Yes, everybody, yes or no? It is ditto same, no change. What we discuss in futures chapter is what here also interest rate futures. Only difference is in futures chapter we discuss about the stock futures and then what? Index future. When we buy and sell share, we buy and sell what? Index, etc. Yes or no? In this chapter, we want to buy and sell what? Interest. Yes or no? Buying interest na receiving interest. Remember? Selling interest means what? Paying interest. Enna puridha? Buying interest means what? Receiving interest. And selling interest means what? Paying interest. Everybody, yes or no? Now, I put a question, you think an answer. Romba simple question. Now, I am going to borrow after 2 months. I am going to borrow after how many months here? 2 months. After 2 months, I am going to pay interest, receive interest. I am going to borrow as a borrower. I am going to what? Pay interest. That means I am going to sell interest after 2 months. Yes, sir. That means I have to go for what? A forward sell. Go for future sell. Are you following? Yes, sir. My strategy is that. Now, suppose I am a depositor. I am going to get a lottery. God came and tell me, you will be winning 100 crore lottery in another what? 2 months. Okay. I am going to earn a lottery after 2 months. I am worried, not whether I win a lottery or not, because God has told me that I am going to win. I am worried about what happens to the deposit rate, if it is going to what? Decrease. Are you following what I am saying? Now, in that case, I am going to get 100 crores after 2 months. I am worried about what? Falling deposit rate. I am going to deposit tomorrow, borrow tomorrow, deposit tomorrow. Don't think deposit, and deposit will be paying interest, receiving interest, sir. A depositor buy interest. Depositor want a buy interest. He is only about a forward buying price or not. So go for what? Your futures buy. Everybody yes or no? Now, how the strategy really works can be seen through what? Numbers. What is the strategy or not? So now if you are going to borrow tomorrow, go for what? Sell interest rate futures. Go for what? Sell interest rate futures. We are going to what? Deposit tomorrow, you're going to go for what? Buy interest rate futures. How it hedges? Is the hedging perfect or imperfect? All this we'll be discussing in what? The next three sums. Everybody, are you following? Huh? More we can learn by actually reading the question in this regard, the interest rate futures. What I told you is, interest rate futures is also similar to FRA. FRA happens between two parties. It happens in what? Stock exchanges. But the modus operandi changes. Interest rate futures works ditto same way any other futures contract works. Like standardized contract size, settlement otherwise through what? Delivery, exiting before what? Maturity date, giving a counter by counter sell, margin money also applies, open interest, mark to market procedure, everything happens for what? Interest rate future. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? But only thing is, in stock futures, I trade in what? Stock prices. In the currency futures, I'll trade in what? Currency rate. Here I trade in what? Interest rate. Buying an interest rate means receiving interest. Selling interest means what? Paying interest. As a person who is going to borrow tomorrow, I'm afraid about what? Future selling price. Hence I go for what? Future sell. If I'm going to deposit tomorrow, I'm afraid about what? The future buying price. Hence go for what? Buy future. So a borrowing person goes for what? Sell interest rate future. Deposit goes for what? Buy interest rate future. After you understood this, then you can further go into the problem and understand how the futures market works. Everybody, are you following?
Yes, sir.
The transaction of Purunja Bhak. Now, take in our workbook question number 5. Again, like forwarded agreement, after I complete 5, 6, 7, then I'll be giving you what? The notes for the interest rate future, where everything will be learned and one go will be having the notes. Okay, now take question number 5. Take question number 5. It is now June 1. In the problem, okay, it's now June 1. In 2 months' time, on August 1, Frog Limited will need to borrow. Frog Limited is leaping forward. Yes, no, leaping what? Forward. Taken from a book called as Loombi, he always uses as good names. Again, this is in every say, problem to indicate the concept. Okay. What is called as Frog Limited here? Frog only jumps somewhat, one place or another. He's going to leap what? Forward. And agree for a forward interest rate. Okay. And earlier was expectation limit has been used or not? Same book only. Can I go see? No. It is now June 1. In 2 months' time, on August 1, Frog Limited will need to borrow rupees 3.9 million for 3 months. What is 3.9 million means? How many lakhs? 39 lakhs for 3 months. So now answer me. Frog Limited is going to borrow today or after 2 months? After 2 months. It is going to borrow after 2 months. How many months? How many months? Yeah, 3 months. Everybody yes or no? Now, next. Frog can currently borrow at 8% per annum, but the treasurer of the Frog fears an increase in interest rate after 2 months and hence wishes to hedge using interest rate futures. September 3 months interest rate futures are currently priced at 93. The standard contract size for futures market is 0.5 million. That means what? 5 lakhs. What strategy should treasurer adopt to hedge the interest rate risk? If on August 1, the futures are priced at 90.75 and the interest rate increases to 10.5%, what would be the effective interest cost paid by Frog Limited due to adoption of this strategy? Also calculate the hedge efficiency. If on August 1, the futures are priced at 94.25 and the interest rate decreases to 6.5%, what would be the effective interest cost paid by Frog Limited due to adoption of this strategy? Also calculate the hedge efficiency. That's the question. Okay, now I'll give you 2 minutes time. Be familiar with what are all the numbers given, terminology is given. So then only when I discuss, you can easily locate the numbers which are being discussed. Okay, go through the problem quickly before I start with the solution. Please go through it. From army number, now let's start with the discussion. Please see, once or twice I'll explain to have a clarity. Carefully follow. Can you shut up now? No. All same story only, but the screenplay different. That's what I'm saying. Now, idampa. Forward agreement also same. Interface also what same. Story is same, but the way it operates what is going to be different. Can I proceed or not? Now, please. Can I start now? See, first of all, there are two markets. How many markets here? Two markets. Cash market and futures market. Cash market and futures market. In cash market, I am going to borrow loan or make deposit really. I am going to go to the bank, borrow loan and deposit really. Now, but to enter into a futures market, it is not necessary that I should borrow and deposit. Again, I say, I can enter into a futures market just for speculation, okay? I can go to a futures market, pay or receive profit and come out without having a loan transaction. The loan is different and the futures market is what? Different. But now what I do is, to hedge my cash market position, I'm entering into what? Futures market. We had a share hedging. Remember, Gabar? A person is long MTNL share worth 10 lakh rupees. You want to protect himself against what? The fall in price. He goes for what? A short future. Something he will discuss. Remember, right or not? Remember, now, like that. A person in real life may require to borrow, may require to what? Deposit on a future date. He is afraid about what? Interest rate change. To protect himself against the interest rate change, and use what? The derivative segment. One of them is what? Interest rate futures. Remember, right or not? Now, see. As usual, futures hedging will not be perfect, like FR and R. It will never be what? Perfect. Because it is not it is a standardized contract size where I cannot hedge as I wish. Everybody follow what I'm saying? But it is effective. It is what? Effective. But it will never be what? Perfect. That is why always they ask you hedge efficiency. How efficiently you want? You hedge in this problem. Can I start or not? No. You are Frog Limited. Frog Limited is going to borrow money tomorrow. Invest money tomorrow. It is going to borrow how much lakhs? That is 39 lakhs, 3.9 million. It is going to borrow how many lakhs? 39 lakhs. It is going to borrow today after 2 months. Today is June 1. They want to borrow only on what? August 1. Now, they are afraid or not? They are going to borrow for how many months? 3 months. They are going to borrow for 3 months. The problem is, today a 3 months interest rate in the market is 8%. But when you go to borrow after 2 months on August 1, frog is afraid about drop in interest or increase interest. If the interest becomes 9%, he has to pay 1% extra. Enough for it or not? So frog is afraid about what? The increase in interest rate. There's an uncertainty in the interest rate payment. Yes or no? He wants to hedge. He wants to what? Hedge. He wants to hedge using forward rate or futures market. Okay. Forward rate agreement, no problem. I can go to the bank today and say, from August 1 to August, September, October, for 3 months, let us enter into what? FRA, they can give me. Yes or no? But in futures market, I will not be getting a contract for a date I like. Are you for what I say? Because the contracts are always predefined by the exchange. Everybody, yes or no? We have September futures, March TCS futures. Remember? Suppose I want to buy a TCS shares on 15th March. Can I ask for 15th March TCS futures? And the futures express only on what? 26 March. Whether you like it or not, you have to buy only 26 March futures because it is not a tailor-made instrument, a standardized product. Yes or no? Yes. The main problem in futures market is, I will not be getting any future that suits my date. Are you following what I'm saying? That means, I have to go for that future is closer to my date. Are you following what I'm saying? Yes. Any approach? No. Say, I want to buy interest or sell interest tomorrow. I want to buy interest or sell interest tomorrow. Sell interest. I am going to borrow tomorrow. I am going to pay interest. I am going to want sell interest. So in the futures market, I should buy interest or sell interest. Sell interest. I am going to sell interest rate futures. Everybody, yes or no? I can sell interest rate futures. I can sell interest rate futures. September futures is there. There may be a December future. There may be what? March future. Always IRF or trade in quarterly. Everybody, yes or no? Now, I have to sell September future because I don't go for December future. The reason is what? Near to August, what is area? September. So this company has decided to sell what future? September interest rate futures. Up to this, are you following or not? No. More will explain with the help of the numbers. No. Can I buzz it? No. Please, all of you participate. First, requirement is borrow 39 lakhs after 2 months. For how many months here? 3 months. This is separate. In what market? Cash market. This transaction risky or not? Yes. I want hedge using what? Futures market. I have to protect myself against what? Increasing interest rate. Strategy in futures market is buy interest rate futures or sell interest rate futures. Sell interest rate futures. Now, number of contracts. Okay. Now, I have to borrow how much lakhs? 39 lakhs. What portion I have in the cash market, the same I have in what? The futures market. I assume no beta for the interest rates. In what I am saying? In that case, futures market value normally is what? Beta times cash market value. Any approach? No. Here assume that cash market interest rate change and future market change is going to be what? Almost same. I don't have the beta also given in the question. I go for a full hedge. Yes or no? In that case, I have to go for number of contracts or not. How much value I have to hedge here? 39 lakhs. Every loan contract size, how much lakhs here? 5 lakhs. So how many contracts here? 7.8. Can I go for 7.8 contracts? No. I only go for what? 8 contracts. That means in futures market, I'll go for sell interest rate future with a notional principle of how much lakhs here? 40 lakhs and not 39 lakhs. So no. I call as notional principle because nobody will borrow 40, nobody will what? Deposit 40. That 40 is only to calculate the interest percentage. Everybody, yes or no? In that case, tell me, in futures market, I enter into a sell futures, buy futures, sell futures. I agree to sell what? Interest rate. Interest rate on what notional principle? 40 lakh because I go for how many contracts? 8 contracts, standardized contracts. Yes or no? In FRA, I can go for what? 39 lakh because tailor made. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? Now, next, this only, I'll explain fully the entire background, okay? Strategy defined. Sell 3 months, September, interest rate futures, 8 contracts, at what? 93. What is the strategy here? Sell 3 months, September, interest rate futures, 8 contracts, at 93. Calmly listen. Can I start or not? No. If you understand the sentence, half the problem over. Can I proceed? Now, see. 93, now, you have to read as 100 minus 7. What is 93 here? 100 minus 7. 7% interest. The one 93 means what? 7% interest. 94 means what? 6% interest. 90 means what? 10% interest. 100 minus futures price gives you the interest rate. Everybody, yes or no? So how to read 93? 100 minus 7. The interest rate is what? 7%. I have agreed for a 7% interest. Agreed for what? 7% interest. Question is, when they agreed? When they agreed? On June 1. When I agreed what? On June 1. Today only enter the future market. I agreed on what? June 1. I agreed on June 1. How much was the interest? 7% interest. For how many months deposit?
3 months.
For how many months amount here? 3 months. For how many months period? 3 months period. The 7% we calculate how many months here? 3 months. And this interest rate, 7% interest rate, is a deposit rate, lending rate bigger. I am selling interest rate. I am what? Selling interest rate. Understand? I have agreed to sell. I have what? Agreed to sell. How much percent interest? 7% interest. I have agreed to pay. How much percent interest? 7% interest. To be calculated for how many period? 3 months period. Yes or no? Yes or no? Now, you can see. Now, first of all. Sell futures, buy futures. I am selling. I am selling what? Share, currency, interest rate, interest rate. I am selling, how much percent interest? 7% interest. Selling 7% interest means what? Pay 7% interest. Inga libar, mibar, and all is not that. Are you following? No, it is as good as straightforward. I am selling 7% interest means what? I am agreeing to pay 7% interest. I am agreeing to pay 7% interest. When I agree? Today. I agree today June 1 to pay how much percent interest? 7% interest for a transaction to take place on what? 30th September. September futures. Yes or no? Now, for a transaction to take place on 30th September, that is for a loan to start, imagine for a loan to start on what? 30th September. I agree for how much interest rate? 7% interest rate. Yes or no? I agree to pay 7% interest rate for a period of how many months here? 3 months. And the fixing date is what? 30th September. Everybody, yes or no? October, November, December, September, December, like I have assumed as a forward rate. So I'm agreeing to pay 7% interest rate. For how many months here? 3%. For which date? 30th September. Yes or no? When I agree here? June 1st. Yes or no? But problem is, I don't want to be in the market till 30th September. The reason is what? I want to borrow only on what? August 1. I want a forward rate on August 1. I don't want a forward rate on what? 30th September. So tell me, should I be in the interest rate market till 30th September? Come out on August 1? Come out on August 1. When I come out by giving what? A counter buying come out. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So now let us see how the hedging strategy works. Okay, now for example, tell me, I go to the futures market. Tell me the date. June 1. Tell me what date? June 1. I select the 3 months futures. Why is that 3 months future? Because I am going to borrow for what? 3 months. If I am going to borrow for 6 months, I go for what? A 6 months interest rate future. The 3 months, 6 months indicate for how many months I'll be calculating what? Interest on the notional principle. Respond yes or no? So I selected a 3 months interest rate. I went to on June 1, the futures market. I selected what? A 3 months future. Selected what? A 3 months future. 3 months futures is a futures contract expiring on what day? September. Explain what? September. That means the contract closes on September. Till then the contract price will be moving up and down. Yes or no? No. That means on 30th September, example, what? On 30th September, I agree to borrow for how many months here? 3 months. At what percent? 7% interest on a notional principle. How much million? How much lakhs? 40 lakhs is the meaning. Everybody, yes or no? Anybody should I explain once again? Can I proceed? Those who want to repeat once again, raise your hand. Okay, one hand, others be. When I said, can I proceed? Na? People didn't answer looking at me. Really following? Should I repeat once again? Na? Okay, one more chance. Those who want to repeat once again, raise your hand. Okay, 100 times, enter the class will raise your hand. Can I proceed? Now. No problem. Listen here. See, understand your cash market. Do a strategy in what? Futures market. You are going to borrow for how many months?
3 months.
Hence, I want to take a portion in futures market. How many months futures? 3 months futures. Point number one, over and out.
Yes, sir.
When you want to borrow? August 1. I search whether any August 1 futures is there or not. Yes or no? It is not there. I go for the nearest future. Nearest future is what? September 30. I want to have a forward rate on August 1. I want to have a forward rate on what? August 1. Market does not provide me. I go for a forward rate on what? 30th September. And then worry different. Because I don't have any other option. Yes, sir. Any puridha? It is not a FRA. It is what? IRF. It is exchange traded. Are you following? No. Since I want to borrow for 3 months, I selected a 3 months futures. Since I wanted to borrow on August 1, that is 2 months hence, I searched for any August futures is there or not. Now that means what? The nearest maturity date is what? September futures. I go for what? A September interest rate futures. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? The reason is, why can't I take December future? The problem is, on August 1, the December future is what? Far away. The future price will not be nearer to cash market price. Basis will be higher. Yes or no? But on August 1 to September, it is nearer, it is going to converge closely. Are you following saying? September 30, actual interest rate and future will be what? Same, because convergence take place. August to September is much more nearer compared to what? August to December futures. Are you following saying? Hence, I should like that future having what? Nearer to my requirement date. Now, tell me, I am going to borrow on what day? August 1. What the future which is the nearer to August 1? September. I go for a September interest rate future. Point number one. Yes or no? There may be 2 September futures here, 3 months future, 6 months future. I have one future, 3 months, because I'm going to borrow how many months here? 3 months. I want the exchange to calculate interest rate for 3 months and not for what? 6 months to do my settlement. Are you following what I'm saying? So I go for a 3 months September future because I'm a loan transaction. Yes or no? Since I'm going to borrow on August 1, I'm afraid about the interest sell. I'm going to afraid about what? Interest sell. I want a selling interest rate. Whatever. What is I'm going to pay interest or receive interest? I'm going to pay interest. Paying interest means what? Selling interest. Since tomorrow I want to sell interest, in the future I want to take what position? Sell position. Yes or no? I want to take what position? Sell position. I'm going to go for sell futures. Yes or no? No. I'm going to sell interest rate futures. What is the amount of loan in the cash market? 39 lakhs. Can I go for a notion principle of 39 lakhs? No. Because they say the standard contract size is 5 lakhs. And to go for how many contracts? 8 contracts. I take a 40 lakhs position to hedge what? A 39 lakhs loan. Yes or no? Perfect. Imperfect, imperfect due to standard contract size. And today in the futures market, now very simple. Today in the spot market, what the interest? 8%. I can say 92. In the spot market, the interest how much percentage? 8%. Same interest in future, how much? 7%. That is 93. What is 7? What is 8? 8% is for the borrowing today. 7 is for what? A borrowing on 30th September. Did you follow what I'm saying? Spot cash market price is what price? Spot price. And future price is what? Future price. Now, the question said, na, today I can borrow how much percent? 8%. If I borrow today, the interest is how much percent? 8%. Today, the bank quotes 8%. The futures market quotes what? 7%. This 8 and 7 are same? No. This 8% is for what? Today's borrowing. The 7% is for what? I'm borrowing to take place on what? September 30th. Enna parita na? Please respond. Are you following what I am saying? So, other difference between 8% and what? 7%. Hence, since I am going to borrow tomorrow, I go for what? A futures interest rate of 7%. How I got 7%? 100 minus 93.
Yes, sir.
Can I proceed further? No. So, let's go to the on maturity date. What is going to happen? Before that, you tell me, what is that I have done today? What I have done today? I went to what market? Futures market. I bought futures, sold futures. I sold futures, na? I sold what futures? Interest rate futures. I am selling what? Interest rate. I sold interest rate at what percent? 7%. Selling at 7% means what? Agree to pay 7%. Since I am selling interest, I agree to pay what? 7%. I agree to pay 7% interest on what principle? 40 lakhs notion principle. And that amount we calculate how many months? 3 months. 3 months future. And agreed to pay 7% interest today on September. On September, this is going to be the transaction. Respond is on. Now, tell me, will I be in that market till September? Because my loan is happening on what? August. Since when I go to borrow in August, I close this portion also, use the profit and last one, net off against the borrowing interest, and then have an effective interest. Everybody has known. Now, I am going to come out voluntarily, or it's going to be on the maturity day. Voluntarily, I'm going to come out on which day? August 1. Look at this. On August, that is, my target interest, for example, had I borrowed today, had I borrowed what? Today, I would have paid on 39 lakhs, 8% for 3 months, 78,000. Since I borrow after 2 months, I don't know whether I continue to pay what? 78 or more than that, or less than that is the issue. So, no, now, my target is 78,000. Is achieved or not is the issue. Now, look at this. On maturity date, now, our maturity is what? August 1. Okay, now. Tell me, look at the workbook. Two questions are asked. Now from now onwards, you should participate and tell me the answer there. First, what is part 2? On August 1, futures are priced at what? 90.75. And interest rate increases in cash market, how much percent? 10.5. My question is, on August 1, I go to the bank and borrow money or not? How much I borrow? 39 lakhs. How many months here? 3 months. At 1% interest? 10.5. When I went to borrow, it became what? 10.5. Crying or laughing or crying? Because today had I borrowed, had I borrowed at what? 8. Had to pay how much percentage? 10.5. No problem. So, cash market, I borrowed 39 lakhs at 1%? 10.5%. How many months here? 3 months. Now, I have to pay interest. How much pays here? 1,02,375. Yes or no? Had I not gone to the futures market, now I am borrowing and paying how much interest? 1,02,375. If I had borrowed today, I would have paid only how much? 78,000. I am crying for some extra money paid. Yes or no? Without hedging, as I felt, I am suffering due to increased interest rate. Yes or no? Now, should I cry? Need not cry? Who is there to wipe out my tears? Futures market. The future is going to obviously have one gain. Because, understand, I am selling futures for 93. When interest rate increases, the 93 becomes 92 or 91. Now 100 minus interest. Now see, futures market, today I have a sell futures for 7%. When cash market interest rate increases, when RBI announces the interest high in cash market, futures market also will increase. Now when the futures market interest rate increases, the futures closing price will be 93 more than 90, less than 93, less than 93. Because suppose increases to 9% means what happens here? 100 becomes what? 91. Since I'm selling at 93, buying at what? 90, book what? 2% profit, I will be taking home the compensation. Everybody understanding it or not? Now tell me, in futures market, I have sold futures. My portion is what? Sell futures. What is sell futures? 93. Now, will I actually borrow money at 7% interest? No. The sell will be closed by giving what? Counter buy. By giving close, by giving what? A counter buy. Now tell me, on the day, the futures market, turning how much up? 90.75. I give a counter buy at what? 90.75. I sell at 93, buy at what? 90.75. Tell me, I'm going to have a profit or loss of profit. How much here? 2.25%. Yes or no? Put in the transaction now. To know more logically, very simple, on September 30, I am agreed to borrow at 7% on June 1. Because June 1, the futures interest, how much percent? 7%. On June 1, I agreed to borrow at how much percent? 7%. On which date? September 30. Yes or no? Again, I go to futures market on what day? August 1. On August 1, I go for what? One more futures contract. I go for what? One more futures contract where I agree to deposit. Since I am buying future, I am buying what? Interest rate. I am buying interest rate. How much I am buying here? 100 minus 90.75 gives you what? 9.25, yeah? Okay, now, very simple. Now I have two futures contracts. How many contracts? Two futures contracts. One is June 1, another is one August 1. Both maturing on what? September 30. So no. Now, very simple. Look at the exchange. With the exchange, I have agreed to borrow at 7%. How much notional principal? 40 million. I also agree to what? Dumpers how much percent? 9.25%. So my open interest is closed. I come out by giving what? Counter sell. So how I come out? I give a counter sell to what? 9.25%. So now tell me my position here. These are the two futures I'm having or not? In that case, first contract says what? I can borrow at 7% on 30th September. Same as what? I can deposit at 9.25. Tell me your net interest payer, interest receiver, interest receiver. In my class profit, respond yes or no. Now, I'm going to have a profit how much percent? 2.25%. This 2.25% will be applied on 1 rupee or 2 rupees. 40 lakhs rupees, sir. How much rupees? 40 lakh rupees. Simply 2.25 into 3 by 12, 3 by 12, because 3 months futures contract. Everybody, yes or no? Now, if I calculate, amount is, one contract size is what? 5 lakh. Always I made how much gain? 2.25% gain. For how many months here? 3 months. Like the how many contracts? 8 contracts. In my margin account, in my what? Margin account, I get the extra credit of 22,500 rupees. Yes or no? I'm paying how much interest? 1,02,375. What the futures market gain? 22,500. The net outflow is what? 79,875. Yes or no? Closer to my 78,000. Remember. It will not be exactly same as 78,000. Too much to expect. The reason is what? The contract sizes are standardized. The futures market and cash market, interest rate need not be same. Because the cash market, it become what at 10.5, 2.5% same. Get back. In futures, only how much at 2.25. Because both are different market, they have their own betas. Are you what I'm saying? In that case, the futures hedging is always what? Imperfect. In the property graph? No. So very simple. The hedge efficiency is profit by loss. What efficiency here? Profit by loss. The profit is how much? 22,500. Loss is 78,000 minus what? 1,02,375. I had a 24,375 loss in cash market. On 22,000 minus the profit in what? Futures market. My hedge efficiency is what? 92.30. That means I achieved almost what? 92.30 percentage of my target outflow. Everybody, yes or no? Idha meekana hedging through interest rate futures. Innappa purinjuda? Can I push it up? No need to worry. Now, this is a situation when the interest rate what? Increases. Interest rate can decrease also, right or not? Now, you should tell me, situation 3. Interest rate in the cash market decreases to what? 6.5%. Futures decreases to what? 94.25. Can I start or not? Now, all of you tell me. On August 1, I go to the bank and borrow how much lakhs? 39 lakhs. And what percent? 6.5. How many months here? 3 months. Here's the 63,375. Agreed? Yes, on the same day, I close my futures or not? No. Today I'm having a buy or sell futures? Buy futures. Sell futures. At what price? 93. Yes or no? No. I give a counter buy, a counter sell? Counter buy. I give a counter buy at what price? 94.25. Profit and loss? Loss. You know, sell at 93. Buy at what? 94.25. Tell me what the loss here? 1.25. This 1.25 should be applied on what principle? 5 lakh. For how many months? 3 months. For how many contracts? 8 contracts. 12,500. Accept or not? Now, can you tell me elaborately? I have agreed to borrow at what percent? So, I agreed to borrow to what percent? 7%. I closed the agreed to borrow by what? Agreeing to deposit how much percent is here? 5.75%. So, no, I agreed to borrow at 7% and agreed to deposit at what? 5.75. I have a loss of what? 1.25. They close and send me out. Is all known? Can you put it now? Same as forward rate. In forward rate, I give a counter at MIBOR. I give a counter at what? MIBOR. Here is not a counter at MIBOR. Counter at what? The given futures price trading on that day. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? That's why I book a profit and loss. Now tell me, how much I pay as interest? 63,375. Plus I have a loss of what? 12,500. Can tell me what is the effective outflow? 75,875. Almost nearer to 78,000. Yes or no? Don't say, sir, had I not gone for futures, I paid only what? 63,375. Agree. Had I not gone for futures, I would have also paid what? 1,02,000 also. My aim is not to profit, my aim is to what? Hedge. And be as close to as possible the 8% range. Everybody understanding or not? Now, in that case, now tell me, my hedge efficiency is profit by loss. Formula is very simple, profit by loss. Can I present or not? Now, tell me, profit is coming in futures market or cash market? Cash market. 78 I should have paid. I paid only what? 63,375. I profit through interest rate decrease. How much rupees here? 14,625. The loss is what? 12,500. The hedge efficiency is 117%. Hence, effective cost has what? Reduced from 78,000 to what? 78,875. Everybody, are you understanding it or not? Now, this is regarding the hedging through interest rate futures. Everybody, Punjidama? Now, please copy the slide quickly. If you have a notes in this regard, after doing one more sum, okay, copy this quickly. So a borrower goes for what futures? Punna buyer bane. Borrower goes for what futures? Sell futures. A depositor goes for what futures? Buy futures. Idhe buyer kuda panikalam ba, no problem. It'll be giving you automatically the required profit and loss in the opposite direction. Is that? If there is an August futures, I will go for September, August. Because in August, the cash market interest rate will be closer to what? Closer to the futures market interest rate. There is much more effective hedging possible. Understand what I am saying? No. Finish coming on. Can take that last line up? No. Target interest is equal to 39 lakhs into 8% into 3 by 12. Target interest is equal to 39 lakhs into 8% into 3 by 12. Is equal to how much? 78,000. See, this target arrow mark has been put. Okay. 39 lakhs into 8% into 3 by 12 is equal to 78,000. Those are not copied. Raise your hand. Can I proceed on? No. Okay. We can write the notes later, but tell me why I go for sell futures? Sulpa. I'm also saying why I go for sell futures? I am borrowing tomorrow. I have to pay interest tomorrow. I am to sell interest tomorrow. Why I go for what? Sell futures. Point number one. Yes or no? No. Why I sell 3 months futures? Because I am going to borrow for 3 months. Why I sell September futures and not December? Because I'm going to borrow on what? August. September only nearest to August. If I have August future, what I will do? Go for August future. Yes or no? I go for one future here? September future, nearer to August. Yes or no? No. So, I sell futures because I am borrowing. I sell what? September future because I am going to borrow on what? August. I also sell what? 3 months future because I borrow for 3 months. You know, understood or not? No. Next is, what is the notional principle? 40 lakh. What is the principle? 40 lakhs. Why 40 lakhs? I have to borrow how many lakhs? 39 lakhs. It is better I go for 39 lakhs. Not possible because of what? Contract size. So I go for the market with what notional principle? 40 lakhs. So no. What the price here? 93. What the meaning of 93? 7%. Now, everybody, corners are sold. Tell me the strategy. Tell me what the strategy is. I have agreed to borrow for how many months? 3 months. In which date? September 30. At what percent? 7%. At what percent? Yeah? 7%. For how many months? 3 months. How much principal? 40 lakhs. Is that meaning? Yes or no? No. on June 1, again I say on June 1, I agreed to what? Borrow and pay how much interest? 7% interest. For how many months, sir? 3 months. Beginning in which date? September 30. Enna paisa nu? For notion principle, 40 lakhs. Enna contract kudunjada? No. Will I really borrow? No. Borrowing will be given a counter through what? Deposit and come out. Enna pa right on earth? No. Next slide. On maturity date, bracket line, maturity date is not 30th September. I exit early na. For me, maturity date is what? 1st August. On maturity date, 1st August, situation 1, copy this. Is coming, huh? A very small slide, only boxes, circles are there. Is coming up. Update what are they? 9:15. Okay, now copy fast. We'll quickly do one problem also. I'm sure 100%. Now finish copying. Does not copy, raise your hand. Stop talking. Can I ever say now? Situation 2. Situation 1, interest rate increases as he feared the futures market protected him. Situation 2, what? Interest decreases. He could not make the use of it because of the loss he is making in the futures market. Okay, now.
Finish coming, huh? Are you understanding and writing it or not? No. See, today interested 8%, listen, keep on writing, also put into ears what I am saying. Today interested 8%, drop to what? 6.5 on August 1. When I went to borrow, I am happy borrowing or not? Yes. Because instead of paying 78, I am paying only what? 63,375 by borrowing on August 1. Since the interest rate has decreased, I am very happy in cash market, right? But what I'm having a loss in future because I agreed to borrow at what? 7%. I give a counter deposit. I give a counter deposit. How much percent? 9, that is 5.75. I'm having a loss of 1.25. Now, sell futures 93. Everybody tell me what is 93 meaning? Agreed to borrow at 7% on September. Buy futures at what? 94.25. Agree to deposit how much percent? 5.75 on 30th September. For both transactions, the date is same. 30th September, is not? Now, both are what futures? September futures only. This transaction entered on June 1. This entered on what? August 1. And both are opposite transaction. The exchange gives a counter and sends me out. Everybody following on? Finish writing, huh? No. 1 minute, all of you tell me. I was having a sell futures at 93, get up. Yes, now on August 1, I am there in the market, out of market, out of market. When you counted what? 94.25. Tell me. But the contract day cancelled, the contract continues, sir. There's another buyer from me, na?
Yes,
there is another seller to me, and that he continues his margin account till the last day. Yes or no? If the other seller happens to be an old buyer, then the open interest gets what? Close, contract cancel. Everybody, remember or not? All open interest concept applies what? In the interest rate futures also. Can I proceed further? Write down, take question number 6. Now, see, stop talking. 5 minutes, we'll complete in what? 5 minutes. Question number 6, I'm not going to read. It is copy and paste what? Question number 5. Only thing is, frog is not going to borrow. Frog is going to what? Deposit. All the other numbers are same. All the other numbers are what? Same. Yes or no? No. Homework club, I understand deposit cancellation or not? No. Can you start doing the solution together or not? No. Everybody? No. We can use the same slide, but then the wordings will what? Change. That's all. Now, tell me, first of all, then we can just write. I am going to borrow what deposit?
Deposit.
Frog is going to deposit how much lakhs? 39 lakhs. After 2 months. How many months here? 3 months. Write on. First, question number 6, requirement. Question number 6, right? Requirement. Please. Give the interest rate future strategy, underline that. Requirement. Borrow. Sorry, deposit, correct one, deposit, 39 lakhs, and I say this is a previous sum, the wordings I am changing, deposit 39 lakhs, after 2 months, for 3 months, deposit 39 lakhs, after 2 months, for 3 months, after 2 months, for 3 months, after 2 months, for 3 months, okay, now, needs to protect against, needs to protect against. Now tell me, he is afraid of increasing interest rate, decreasing. When he goes deposit, what happens? 8% becomes what? 6. He's going to put what? Decreasing interest rate. So need to protect against what? Falling interest rate. Needs to protect against falling interest rate. Again, slide, don't get misled. In the previous some slide. Okay, needs to protect against falling interest rate. Strategy in futures market. Strategy in futures market.
Now stop and tell me, tomorrow I am going to deposit a borrow deposit. Depositor is going to pay interest or receive interest? Or? Receiving means what? Buying interest. I am going to buy interest tomorrow. So go for what? Buy interest rate futures. Yes or no? No. So go for standard in future market as what? Buy interest rate futures. Buy interest rate futures. Buy interest rate futures. Number of contracts. Number of contracts. 39 lakhs divided by 5 lakhs. Number of contracts. 39 lakhs divided by 5 lakhs. Is equal to? 7.8 contracts or 8 contracts. Is equal to 7.8 contracts or 8 contracts. Strategy defined. Strategy defined. Tell, I'll put in the slide. What strategy? Yeah. By 3 months, 8 September futures contract at what price? 93. By 3 months, September interest rate futures 8 contracts. By 3 months, September interest rate futures 8 contracts at 93. By 3 months, September interest rate futures 8 contracts at 93. Up to this, are you following or not? Now, don't get irritated. One time you tell, I'll proceed. What is the strategy? I have agreed to. When I agree? June 1. June 1, I have agreed to borrow what? Deposit? Deposit. I agreed to deposit and notional principal worth how much? 40 lakhs. For how many months? 3 months. On which date? September 30. At what interest rate? 7%. Is the meaning. Next. Step number 1 or 2? 2. Before that, target interest. Target interest. 39 lakhs into 8% into 39 lakhs into 8% into 3/12. 39 lakhs into 8% into 3/12. 39 lakhs into 8% into 3/12. How much the target interest? 78. I am happy if I receive what? 78,000. More happy if I receive what? More. Unhappy if I receive what? Less. Let us see what is going to happen on August 1. Can I proceed or not? No. Let's do it together. Next. On August 1. On August 1, interest rate increases. On August 1, interest rate increases. On August 1, interest rate increases. Tell me, I am going to be there in how many markets? Can name the two markets. One is what? Cash market. Another is what? Futures market. Cash market and then futures market. Cash market, borrow or deposit? Deposit. Deposit. How much rupees? 39 lakh rupees. Tell me, on August 1, what happened to interest rate? Look at the second point. And what happened to interest rate? Interest rate increases to 10.5%. Happy or not? Yes. 39 lakhs at 1%, 10.5%. How many months? 3 months. Now tell me, interest paid or received? Received is equal to 39 lakhs into how much percent? 10.5% into 3/12. Can anybody calculate and tell me 39 lakhs into 10.5 into 3/12? What's the number I'm going to get? 1,02,375. Had a deposit at today, would have gained only 78,000. Since a deposit on August 1, very happy, became what? 1,02,375. Happy or not? Yes. Is the happiness forever? No. It is going to be made unhappy through what? Loss in futures market. Now, today, my position is futures buy or sell? Buy. I have a buy futures at 93. I come out on August 1 by giving a counter sell at how much? 90.75. The counter sell at 90.75. My question is the gain or loss? Or loss. Loss is equal to how much percent? 2.25%. Yes or no? No. Let's quantify the margin amount loss. Amount of loss is equal to, tell me the calculation. 5 lakhs into 2.25% into 3/12. Loss for every contract. Yes or no? You know how many contracts here? 8 contracts. Tell me, what is the loss amount? 22,500. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? No. Write down. Next. Can you continue writing or not? No. Write down. Interest paid. Sorry, interest received. Interest received is 1,02,375. Interest received 1,02,375. Next is what? Futures loss. For the loss in futures market, 22,500. Net interest received. What amount here? 79,875. Still, I'm happy because I have extra 1,000 or not. Yes or no? No. 79,875. Next. Hedge efficiency. Always the formula is simple. Profit by what? Loss. Any market profit will be there. Any market loss will be there. Profit by loss. Now, please tell me. I have a profit in cash market or futures market or cash market. Tell me. I should have received what? 78. I received what? 1,02,375. Can you tell me what is the profit I am making here? 24,375. I have a cash market profit. I have future market loss of what? 22,500. Can anyone tell me the hedge efficiency? 108.33%. Hedge efficiency is 108.33%. Hedge has not protected me, has given me something more than what I wanted. Yes or no? Hedge efficiency is 108.33%. Enough for respond. Yes or no? No. Last point. On August 1, please. Let's work and go home. Okay. On August 1. On August 1, interest decreases. Above this one, I'm very worried about. What am I interested? Falls. Who is that to protect me? Futures. Okay, interest decreases. Answer me, I'm having portion how many markets? Two markets. Cash market and then what? Futures market. On August 1 in cash market, I'm going to what? Deposit. How much lakhs? 39 lakhs. At that time, what is interest rate? 6.5, yeah? At 6.5% for how many months? 3 months. Interest received is equal to interest is equal to calculated. It is 39 lakhs into 6.5% into 3/12. What interest is it? 63,375. Happy, unhappy, unhappy. Had a deposit today, I would have received how much? 78. I'm unhappy about 63,375. Right or not? No. Come to the futures market. I'm having a futures buyer seller. Buy. I'm having a futures buy at what? 93. When I want to exit, the exchange gives me a counter sell. At how much? 94.25. Count as 94.25. Answer me. Profit or loss? Profit. What a profit here? 1.25%. Profit is 1.25%. Now, the amount of profit is equal to, what is the notional principle? 5 lakhs per contract. In how much percent? 1.25%. For how many months? This is one contract. How many contracts here? 8 contracts. Then what is the profit amount? 12,500. The profit amount is 12,500. Profit is 12,500. Everybody respond. Are you falling or not? No. Next. Can I go to the next part? No. Write down. Interest received. Interest received. How much interest I received? 63,375. Add what? Futures market gain. 12,500. Add futures gain 12,500. Total realization. What is the realization? 75,875. Total realization 75,875. Everybody understood or not? No. Next is what? Hedge efficiency is equal to profit by loss. Tell me, I make profit in cash market or futures market or future. For the profit, 12,500. Cash market profit and loss are loss. I should have received 78,000, receive only what? 63,375. What the loss amount? 14,625. What is hedge efficiency? 85.47%. Hedge efficiency is 85.47%. Respond, are you following or not? This is regarding the interest rate futures. Have you understood or not? Now.